today's post-COVID world, minimize the distance. We're not in a lecture hall stepping down off stages to minimize the distance. We're on Zoom calls and email and LinkedIn. And how do we minimize the distance in today's environment?
The fifth commandment is an interesting one because for hundreds of years, when you went into school especially, there was a master and there was a student. And the master, over the course of time, would stand at a pulpit and they would talk. And the reason they did that, when information was scarce, it was generally contained in the mind of the teacher. And even before books were written, the way that they would teach you is they would talk to you and they would start to convey a whole lot of information. Well, in the 1980s and 1990s, all of that changed when technology allowed all of us to be able to learn in a way that was contrary to the past 5,000 years. So when we think about how we communicate now, the most effective way as a visual element of how we learn is to watch a TED Talk. And notice what happens on the TED stage. When somebody comes out, the first thing you will notice, there are no barriers. They are not behind a podium, they are not behind a desk, they are right at the front of the lip of a stage. Their hands, their eyes, their smile, everything is exposed. And in most cases, they don't even hold a microphone in their hand. I don't like to hold a microphone in my hand because I want my hands to be visible. They generally tie a mic. They have a lavalier. It's either tied to their lapel or it's tied to their ear. And you'll notice they often do that so that their hand's free. This is in stark contrast to the way we used to learn, where the professor or even the priest in a school, in church, would stand either at a pedestal or behind a podium. And the problem with that is it was a great deal of distance between the communicator and the listener. The more distance you have from the person you are communicating with, the further away that connection feels. So I'm not suggesting that we have to speak to somebody within just a couple of inches. What I am suggesting for this chapter, it's called minimize the distance. When you want to connect with somebody, get close to them. Not in their face, but have a little bit of distance. So rather than speaking to them away, you will find it's much more effective that people are dialed into your speaking style when they feel that you have made a commitment to speak to them in a way that is much closer than apart. So welcome to Minimize the Distance.
I've watched you in person, in speeches, step down off of stages and walk to the crowd and literally minimize the distance and engage with them in personal space. I also think it'd be interesting to hear your thoughts on, you know, in today's post-COVID world, minimize the distance. We're not in a lecture hall stepping down off stages to minimize the distance. We're on Zoom calls and email and LinkedIn. And how do we minimize the distance in today's environment?
Well, I think it's being conscious of the fact that minimizing the distance in a technological world is about the eye contact and about being sensitive to the fact that you are dialed in and you are listening. Minimize the distance is all about speaking with purpose and listening with intent. And part of how you speak with purpose is recognizing that you are speaking exactly to one person at a time. So even if you're speaking to 30 people, you want them to feel that you're speaking directly to them. And the way you do that is with eye contact and with hands. So you can point to them, you can see them. I don't think it's any different. Even though we are not physically in a classroom or on a stage, the reality is you want to create some sense of intimacy. Often when we get together with our producing partners, there is that strong sense of intimacy. We like each other. We want to be in each other's gravity. So we tend to just very naturally get close to each other. And I think that's the best way to model a speaker, a teacher that is trying to connect with an audience or with a classroom. The more that we can look at them, that we can make them feel that, hey, we see you. You exist. It's a very simple technique, but some people don't do that. They talk to the back of a wall. Well, if you do talk to the back of a wall, the only person you're landing your message with is the wall. And the wall can't love you the wall can't talk to you, the wall can't admire you because it doesn't know what to do with what you said, you're speaking to an inanimate object. Well, we're speaking to people, and people have the ability to land, to connect, and to give back to you. And that's really what we want. We want to give information so that you can give it all back. Just give and take. That's what Minimize the Distance is about.
When we're taking a Zoom call on a Tuesday morning, we're with people in their kitchen. Their kids are in the background. Like, this is entry into, once again, and you've talked about this before, and I think it's never been exemplified better, this collapse of what's been standing between personal and professional identity. And all of a sudden, COVID-19 smashes that gap and it brings it together. We are living the one life model now.
There's one other thing that unfortunately we're missing, and I think it's a power of nature. We are missing the intimacy and the bonds that we've been doing for most of our lives, except for the last 4 months. Right now, we are living in what feels like a very artificial world because we're not out there greeting dinner. You and I, we haven't had dinner in months, and not because we haven't wanted to, but because the world doesn't allow it.
Yeah.
So part of this is compensating for the fact that nature has been voided from the nature, and the nature is about all of us getting together in a communal way and really inspiring and learning from each other. This technological world has taken away a lot of the natural elements we use to both learn and connect. So this is where we are. We've got to compensate for the fact that if nature is taking something away, then our compensation is we have to work extra hard to bring that intimacy back. If you have 6 things to say, you're either going to decide on 3 or you're going to cut the 6 in half.